Tommy, with the release of this book, do you find yourself maybe leaning more towards producing films that may be more consistent with themes that you've published in the book, or to continue to do the various different type of films that you've done?
It's a tough question, because on a human level, you know, and that's the other thing, is that just having a conversation with you, we can talk about shit all day long, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I could take it up to, you know, fa sol la ti do, you know, like all the way up to do, let's just talk about this, right?
Yeah.
And on this level right here, I would love to make westerns, I would love to make kung fu, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
I just love that, but because I'm making that movie, it's always going to be a reflection of the conglomerate, you know, everybody that's working together on it.
Mm-hmm.
But if I write it and direct it and edit it and everything, there's going to be messages in it.
Mm-hmm.
I won't even see some of those messages until I watch it the 10th time.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'll be like, wow, I didn't even realize I did that. Mm-hmm. You know, so I want to keep my stuff lighthearted for the most part, but then that might change. You know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. as I change as an artist and as a person, I might want to make a real serious film, you know? I mean, I like, everybody always tells me, you got to do a documentary about Niagara Falls. And like, the reason I haven't is because I feel like I'm living it. And if I start filming what I'm living every single day,
yeah,
I'm going to go out of my mind. You know what I mean? I won't even know what to put in and what to leave out. Same thing like my book, you know?
Yeah.
So I would rather, and this is what I'm working on right now, I would rather get to a point where I can produce up-and-coming filmmakers, because even though I'm still young, I've been at it for long enough that I'm not up-and-coming anymore, you know? Mm-hmm. I've established myself. So, mm-hmm. like, I produced a movie called I Dare You to Open Your Eyes, which mm-hmm. the girl who wrote and directed and edited it was 16 at the time,
mm-hmm.
from Niagara Falls. So, mm-hmm. it was a fantastic film. It just hit North Park Theater at its premiere, and it was way beyond like where I was at when I was 16.
Mm.
Like, the way she edited it was like Quentin Tarantino.
Wow.
I find more pleasure in seeing somebody else's kung fu as it develops.
Yeah.
Because I know my kung fu, you know what I mean?
Mm.
So I just want to be able to put energy into watching younger generations, especially her being a female director, because there's not a lot of them in the world, you know?
Yeah.
And so I'm kind of, even though I direct and I write and, you know, do the whole thing, right now I'm leaning towards producing, just so that I can help others realize their potential.
Man, that says a lot, man, about you and your character, because you have a lot of people who have that kind of life experience, and they're not willing to help the next generation and actually enjoy seeing them be successful in their undertakings. I mean, what would you call that? How would you describe what that feeling is?
You know? Like my own, or described?
Yours. You know what I mean? I know what that is.
Yeah, because that's how we got the 9 to 5, you know, 8 to 10, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, the world that we live in is because of that mindset.
Yeah.
It's altruism. That's all, you know. Altruism is my personal philosophy, because I know that we are all a big family, you know. So
I mean, is that something that is just innate, or can a person learn to be that way?
Absolutely, anybody can learn altruism. I mean, for some people it takes a smack on the side of the head, you know, from reality, whether they lose a loved one, or, you know what I mean, like they get sick, or they just lose their job that they've had for a really long time. And,
mm-hmm.
you know, I mean, like, you got the haves, you got the have-nots, and there's an old saying that a man who is well-fed cannot understand a man who's hungry, you know, and it's true. So to make yourself always understanding, to keep yourself hungry, to stay hungry, that's how you understand people who are struggling and people who need help, and, you know, maybe people who are not as fortunate as you are. And like, I always look at it as, we have to have something to measure ourselves against. Mm. For Christians, that would be Christ. Mm. For Buddhists, that would be the Buddha. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So if you're measuring yourself against a 6-inch measuring stick, like, you're not going to grow beyond that. You know what I mean? And not only that, but you're going to go by intervals that are smaller and slower.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
It's like in the movie Ray with Jamie Foxx, you know, when Paul Giamatti's like, well, you're thinking pennies. I want you to think dollars.
Mm.
You know? And that's it. How many people do you know that say, like, oh, well, one day I might do it?
Mm.
You know, it's like, today's the day. If you are serious about it, you know, like, if you wanna be a world-class guitar player, then you better own a guitar.
Yeah.
You know, and if you talk about doing it and you don't have a guitar, then I don't know why you're sitting here talking to me when you could go out and get a guitar.
Mm.
You know, it's as simple as that. Like, the Buddha said, the problem is you think you have time.
Mm.